after the group stage of Euro 2020, things have panned out pretty expectedly, honestly, not too many surprises in the group stage. As far as predicting the tournament's been going for the group stage, I got quite a few things right, I got some things wrong, you know, pretty standard for these major tournaments where, especially in the group stage of just three games, you know, you have one bad game and everything can go wrong for you. But here we are, the round of 16 is starting this weekend, and these are the 16 teams that are contesting. We have Belgium, Portugal, Italy, Austria, France, Switzerland, Croatia, Spain, Sweden, Ukraine, England, Germany, Netherlands, Czech Republic, and Wales, Denmark. And here is how I think this round of 16 is going to play out. Starting right off the bat with one of the two biggest matchups in the round of 16, Belgium versus Portugal. Two teams that are in this tournament to win it. Belgium, for their golden generation, one of their last big chances to win a major tournament, and Portugal, the defending Euro Cup champions and the defending Euro Nations League champions. Two very different paths to this point for these two teams. Belgium walking through an easier group, coming in first, and Portugal in the group of death, coming in third, tied on points with Germany. Now that makes things very interesting, because you have a Belgium team who is at 9 points, first place in their group, coming off of easy wins against Denmark, Finland, and Russia, and you have a Portugal team that tied France well, beat Hungary 3-0, but they needed to wait until past the 80th minute to get all three of those goals, and then lost pretty disappointingly 4-2 to Germany. So this is a Portugal team that has kind of been all over the place, but been playing against tough competition against the Belgium team that has consistently been beating not so good competition. What that leads to is a match that's a pretty major toss-up. I'm leaning towards Portugal just because they have more experience at winning these tight games at major competitions, as I said, defending Euro champions, beating France in the end of the last Euro. They just tied France in a game that they need to get a point out of. So they already, this tournament, have done what they need to do to move on. Belgium hasn't faced adversity yet. So this is going to be Belgium's first real tough facing of much adversity, whereas for Portugal, they faced serious adversity in all three games they've played. So just because they're more accustomed to it, just because they have more experience at coming out of these tough games, I'm going to lean towards Portugal for this match. Next, Italy-Austria. This is a pretty easy one. Italy was very, very good in the group stage. Won all three games in their group, did not concede a single goal. Austria, on the other hand, was kind of iffy in the group stage. Beat North Macedonia, did not play well at all against Netherlands, and then beat Ukraine 1-0 on the final match day. In their one game, though, against a team that was close to what Italy is capable of, they did not play well against the Netherlands. So because of that, Italy, easy favorites to win this match. Next, France-Switzerland, another pretty easy one. France defending World Cup champions, first place in the group of death over Portugal and Germany. Switzerland, third place in Group A, behind Italy and Wales, lost Italy, drew Wales. I don't see with that repertoire them being able to really challenge France for this match. France takes it. Croatia versus Spain. This is another very interesting one. It's Croatia and Spain, two quite good teams that really had disappointing starts to this tournament. Croatia sitting on 1 point going to the final match day, Spain sitting on 2 points going to the final match day, and then both came alive in the final match day of the group stage. Croatia beating Scotland 3-1, Spain beating Slovakia 5-0. This is essentially a matchup of two teams that have just come alive, and the fact that it's the two teams that just came alive that are facing each other in their first knockout stage game is actually pretty funny. Overall, I think Spain just has slightly more depth. In their come alive game, they came slightly more alive than Croatia did. I'm giving them the slight edge over Croatia in this match. Moving over to the other side of the bracket, Sweden versus the Ukraine. Sweden, unexpectedly, was fantastic in the group stage, won their group, finishing above Spain. The Ukraine is coming off of a loss to Austria, which is a team that I think they really should have beaten. Overall, so far to this point, Sweden's been having the better tournament, and I see them continuing that and winning this game. Next, we have the second of two big games in the round of 16. England versus Germany. England, a kind of disappointing group stage, only scoring 2 goals, Raheem Sterling getting both of them, beating Croatia and the Czech Republic 1-0 each, and then drawing Scotland 0-0. Germany, on the other hand, had a 4-2 win over Portugal, tied Hungary 2-2 and lost to France. So what has to happen here is England needs to find their scoring touch or else they're screwed. And to go and find their scoring touch against Germany, that is a very high task for Gareth Southgate's squad. Honestly, all the games that England have played so far have been quite boring. All the games that Germany have been in so far have been very exciting, high-scoring matches. And I just don't see England right now being able to go up against Germany with the type of style of play that Germany has and come out of that game on top. I think this game is going to have more goals than any of the England games have so far, which, like, they should. They've only had 2 goals in 3 games so far. But they just haven't shown the ability to get the goals required against teams that are easier to score against than Germany. So I think Germany should be able to slide through this one. They just have set the precedent of being able to get the goals they need in this tournament. And against an England squad, which really hasn't shown that, that should be enough to push them through. Netherlands versus the Czech Republic. Czech Republic had a solid group stage, beating Scotland, drawing Croatia, losing to England. The Netherlands, on the other hand, walked through their group of North Macedonia, Ukraine, and Austria pretty easily. The Czechs are a solid squad, good at defending, have been able to get a few goals when they need them. However, I think the Dutch team just is a little too much for them to be able to handle, and I feel like the Dutch, having beaten Austria, have been beaten the Ukraine. Those are two teams that I feel like are on about the same level, maybe just slightly lower than the Czech Republic. They beat those two teams, so there's no reason why they shouldn't be able to beat the Czech Republic. I see the Netherlands going through. And finally, Wales, Denmark. For Denmark, I thought what happened with Christian Eriksen was going to be the end of them. I thought that was going to demotivate them for the rest of the tournament. Instead, it incredibly motivated them. They had a fantastic performance against Belgium, unfortunately lost 2-1, and then had that huge win over Russia on the final day of the group stage, ending the group in second place in the incredibly rare 9-3-3-3 points distribution in the group. Going up against a Welsh team that had a solid group stage, drawing Switzerland, beating Turkey. However, I think Denmark is just galvanized right now, and while Wales should be a fair competition for Denmark right now, I think Denmark just has a little extra emotional motivation, and that should be able to carry them through this match. Now on to the quarterfinals. Portugal versus Italy. Another incredibly tough game. Honestly, this half of the bracket is just completely messed up compared to that side. This is the much harder half. To be honest, I really liked what I saw from Italy in the group stage. This looks like a team that is going for it. Portugal, obviously, they're the defending champions. They'd be just coming off of a win against Belgium if they were to be here. But this is an Italy squad that seems galvanized. This is an Italy squad that looked a lot more solid in the group stage than Belgium, in my opinion. I can see Italy taking a real solid run at Portugal, and because of that, I honestly think Italy has a solid shot at pushing through this match and going on to the semifinals. So I'm going to choose them as my quarterfinal winner here. Also, side note, an Italy-Portugal game might destroy my hometown of Toronto. This match would probably divide the city more than any other football match ever could. Next, France versus Spain. Defending World Cup champions, which in my opinion have gotten better since they won the World Cup, versus a Spanish team that is solid, but honestly, the level of France, I don't think so. France, again, beat Germany, tied Portugal. Spain is a very good team, but I would actually say that they're probably slightly behind Portugal and Germany right now. So France, after the performances they had against those two, should be able to beat Spain, go through to the semis. Other side, Sweden versus Germany. Now on paper, you know, this should be Germany's game. Better team on paper, better team historically. However, Sweden has been very interesting this tournament. Tied Spain, came first place in their group. Playing it safe, I'd say Germany should take it, but usually in these tournaments, there's one shock team in the semifinals. So, like, not a huge shock, but like a team you're like, wow, that's good for them. And this tournament, I really do think that surprise semifinal team is going to be Sweden. And finally, the Netherlands, Denmark. Yes, I said Denmark is galvanized. Are they galvanized enough to beat the Netherlands? That is a very tough question. This, again, is going to be an incredibly close matchup. Another matchup where I think penalties is a real possibility. However, while I do think Denmark has been galvanized enough to be able to easily beat teams like Wales, like Russia, I don't think they're at the level where they could take down teams at the level of the Netherlands. I know the Netherlands is kind of a 1B team in Europe right now, but I do think the Netherlands are still slightly above the level that this current Denmark team can do. It's a very, very, very tight matchup, but I think the Netherlands have a very, very slim edge in terms of talent level. So I do think the Netherlands are going to move through this game into the semis. And now, Italy versus France in the semifinals. Wow, okay. Italy galvanized this tournament, very good. France, honestly, right now, in terms of national teams, France is the best team in the world. And I really just don't see much stopping them. So I'm picking France in this matchup. Italy, great right now, but France, just Mbappe, Benzema, Conte, Pogba, they're just on another level. So I see France taking this match. And on the other side, Sweden versus the Netherlands. This is kind of a little bit of a drop-off, you know, Italy versus France on one side, and I have Sweden versus the Netherlands on the other side. If Sweden gets through the winner of England-Germany, they have a very, very easier matchup in the semifinals. The Netherlands or Denmark are the two most likely options. And, well, the Netherlands are a solid squad and a historically strong squad in Europe. They're not as strong as they have been historically, A, and B, they're not as strong currently as I'd rate England or Germany. However, Sweden would need a hell of a performance to get past England or Germany, which is what I'm banking on for this. The question is, can they do it twice? They wouldn't need to be as good as they were, but they'd still need to play significantly above their level to beat the Netherlands. And can they play above their level in two back-to-back games to beat two teams that on paper should have an advantage over them? I can count on Magic striking once when they beat Spain, twice for them to get through to the semifinals. I can't count on Magic striking three times in the same tournament for Sweden. So, for that reason, I think Netherlands are going to have the slight edge, so I'm going to say the Netherlands are going through to the finals. And so, the finals of Euro 2020, according to me, is going to be France versus the Netherlands. Honestly, there's a lot like what happened in the World Cup in 2018, where France was on the hard side of the bracket, and the other side of the bracket was England-Croatia. And essentially, the winner of France's side of the bracket was the obvious winner, an obvious favorite to win the World Cup. Same thing, this side of the bracket, Portugal, Belgium, Italy, France, Spain, Croatia. Whoever comes out of this side of the bracket is the obvious favorite to win the Euro Cup right now. This is just an immensely harder bracket. The semifinals of this side is very close to being the Euro Cup final. Netherlands, for them to get here, they'd have an immensely easier path than France and really would not have a challenge on the level of what France is, or really that close to what France is, especially if Sweden takes out Germany or England, or if Ukraine takes out Germany or England. So they'd be going up against a team the likes of that they have not been close to seeing at the Euro. France would have taken out multiple teams better than the Netherlands to this point. France right now is the best team in the world by quite a bit on the international level. So France are my pick to win Euro 2020. So, there you have it. My predictions for Euro 2020's knockout stage. France is going to win it all. Let me know down below in the comments who you think is going to come out on top at the Euros. And as always, if you like this video, hit like. If you want to see more of my stuff, hit subscribe. Follow me on Twitter. Link is down below in the description. And I will see you next time.